Salve has had an overall record in her tenure of 75-35. That's very, very impressive. This year, her senior year, she led the team to an overall record of 25-4, a 20-game winning streak, a conference title, undefeated 13-0 in the conference, and an NCAA bid. She was ranked third in the conference in scoring at 17 points a game, fourth in block shots, fifth in steals, and eighth in rebounding. She's a two-time first-team all-conference selection, D3 Hoops Women's All-Northeast second team, as well as ECAC second team in the Northeast. 2 years in a row, she has won the award, the Cox Award for the best Division III women's basketball player in the state of Rhode Island. She has finished her career second all-time scoring at Salve Regina with 1,498 points. She also is second, all-time in field goals and ranked fourth in block shots and steals, seventh in rebounding. You know, and we always talk about numbers as coaches because it's something like that's really concrete. But the thing I want to say most about Erin is that I'm very impressed with her growth over the last 4 years. And I know that I've been very hard on Erin. You know, Erin is one of those people that is just a tremendous athlete. She's the best athlete I've ever coached. And she's the kind of player that walks into a room, and every coach in here can attest to this. You just go, wow. You just know she's an athlete. She walks like an athlete. She moves like an athlete. She's an athlete. Everything she does, she's good at. You know, and that's a compliment. You know, I'm not trying to be fresh about it. I'm just very, very impressed with her athleticism, and I always expected more of her. And when you hear all of these things that she's done here, like what else could she do? You know, what she could do is take a step back and not try to be perfect. Because I think for 4 years, that's what she tried to do. And that's hard. It's hard to try to live up to that every day. And I think I saw for 4 years, Erin struggle with that, trying to be perfect. She had high expectations for herself, and she also had for her teammates. And it showed sometimes. She struggled, and I think she'd be the first person to say that. You know, and when she sat in my office at the end of the year, we had our exit interview type thing, you know, she said, I wish I got it a little sooner. You know, well, Erin, you got it. You know, and that's the important thing. You really did. And in the conference championship game, Erin scored 30 points. She shot 65% from the floor. She was 3-for-5 from the three-point line. She had 13 rebounds. She had 3 blocks. And she committed only 2 turnovers in 40 minutes of play. And oh, she also defended their best player and held her to 8 points. But what I'm most impressed with is that she had 6 assists in that game. And I'm proud of her for that. You know, that's pretty much as close as perfection as you can get. And we wouldn't have won a conference championship this year without Erin Phillips. And I just want to thank her for that.
What she said. Erin, come on up. Yeah. I've had the pleasure and the privilege of coaching Erin Phillips. But before I had that pleasure and privilege of coaching her, I got to watch her as the sports information director, because she didn't play tennis her freshman year. She played basketball. When she did, I'm like, oh, yes. And what Cori said is true. She is a perfectionist. She wants to be the best. And we saw her become the best. She scored 1,498 points in basketball. I'm not adding it, Erin. I didn't see it. I'm not adding it. Which is second most all time in the history of women's basketball at Salve Regina. But I'm here to tell you today, she scored more points in tennis than she could ever score in basketball. She's done the math. I've done the math. You've got to win 48 points to win one match. And she won a lot of matches. She was our number one singles player for her all 3 years, our number one doubles player for all 3 years. She, like Cori said, I've been coaching here since 1992, and I have not seen any athlete that compares with Erin Phillips. In a good way. In a good way. And it's obvious when you see the basketball game, you see that athleticism. When you come up to the tennis court, you see that athleticism. And I can tell you countless of times when her dad, Andrew, and her mom, Kathy, and I would just gasp when she would go sliding for a wide shot. And like, is she going to get back up? Yes. The answer was yes. She got back up every single time. And it was amazing. But what makes Erin Phillips a more special athlete to me is her stand-up comedian work. She is a team player. In a sport of tennis, you don't consider a team sport. She brought that to our women's tennis program, being a team player, looking after her teammates. She doesn't get assists in the sport of tennis, which if we were able to hand out an assist, she'd be the all-time leader in assists for the women's tennis program. So thank you, Erin Phillips.
Supporting me through everything and allowing me to come to this beautiful school. I'd also like to thank my four older brothers, Tommy, Kevin, Mark, and Jimmy. I know they appreciate that I shouted them out, so. Just basically for letting me play with them, even though I was a little annoying little sister. I'd also like to thank the whole athletic department for all their support throughout my career. It's been great. I would love to thank Coach Habershaw and Coach Hughes for allowing me to play the two sports that I love the most, and just helping me grow as an athlete and a person. And finally, I would like to thank my teammates.
Thank you.